In this video, we're going to finish the trigonometric ratios worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the geometry section. Our directions in this next part are to find the value of each trigonometric ratio to the nearest 10,000th. So remember, in decimals, we have our tenths, hundredths, our thousandths, and then our 10,000ths. So we're going to go 4 after the decimal point. That is what we're rounding to. Also remember, SOHCAHTOA. Sine is opposite over hypotenuse, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is opposite over the adjacent. In number 11, we're looking at the cosine of z. So our angle z, opposite z is 9, adjacent z is 12, and the hypotenuse is 15. And remember, adjacent is the side that touches or helps form that angle, but is not the hypotenuse. So for cosine, we're going to be looking at A over H, adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent over hypotenuse is 12 over 15. And since we're rounding to the nearest 10,000th, we can enter that in on our calculator. 12 divided by 15 is 0.8. However, we're rounding to the nearest 10,000th, so that's 0.8000, 4 places after the decimal point. In number 11, we're looking at the cosine again, so we need adjacent over hypotenuse. And if it's the cosine of angle C, the side that's the hypotenuse is directly across from the 90 degree angle, so that's 45, and the adjacent side is 27. So adjacent over hypotenuse is equal to 27 over 45. And when I enter that into the calculator, the cosine of C is equal to 0.6. However, we're rounding to the nearest 10,000th, so we need 4 places after the decimal. 0, 0, 0. So 0.6, 0, 0, 0. In number 13, we have the tangent of C. Tangent, think, toa. So we're looking for opposite over the adjacent. And if our angle is C, opposite C, we have 40, and adjacent C, we have 30. So this is 40 over 30. Entering that into our calculator, 40 divided by 30 is 1 3/10 repeating. So that'll be 1.3333. In number 14, the tangent of A, toa. We're looking for the side opposite A. Since this is the tangent of A, opposite A is 21 over adjacent to A, the other leg, which is 20. Typing that into our calculator, 21 divided by 20 is 1.0500. In number 15, the tangent, think, toa. So for C, we're looking for the opposite over the adjacent. Here is C. Opposite that angle C is 12, and adjacent to C is 35. Since BC helps form that angle C, but it is not the hypotenuse. 12 divided by 35 is 0.342, and then it's 85, but we'll round that up to 0.3429. In number 16, again, we're looking for the tangent. However, this time it's the tangent of x. So we're looking for the side opposite x and adjacent to x. Here is angle x. Opposite x is 30, and adjacent to x is the side touching that's not the hypotenuse. So you can see that xz is the hypotenuse, therefore adjacent will be xy of 40. And 30 divided by 40 is the same as 3/4, which is 0.7500. In number 17, we're looking for the sine of z. Sine, think so. And since our angle is z, we need the opposite of z and the hypotenuse within the triangle. The hypotenuse we know is always across from that 90 degree angle. So the hypotenuse is 37. Our opposite, however, depends on the angle. And since we're looking at angle Z, opposite Z is 12. 12 divided by 37 is 0.3243. And then there's a 2 after this 3, so I'm rounding it down to 3. So 0.3243. For the sine of Z, that's opposite over hypotenuse. So you can think, so sine equals opposite over hypotenuse. The opposite side from Z has a measure of 30 and the hypotenuse has a measure of 50. So this is 30 over 50 or 3/5, which is equivalent to 0.6000. And that's the solution in number 18. In number 19, as opposed to giving us a triangle, they now give us a degree. So this is actually very easy to type into our calculator. In number 19, it says the sine of 48 degrees. So we need to make sure our calculator is in degree mode, DEG. And then you can simply press sine and then type in your degree, 48. The sine of 48, you can see, is 0.74314, which will round to 0.7431. So the sine of 48 degrees is 0.7431. And while I'm here, I'll do the cosine of 61 degrees. So on our calculator, type in the cosine and then 61 degrees, and that's going to be equal to 0.48480. So 0.4848. Now on to number 20 and 22, we have the sine of 38. The sine of 38 degrees is equal to 0.61566. So the 6 will round up to 7. So that's going to be 0.6157. 0.6157. And for the cosine of 51, type cosine and then 51 degrees, 0.6293. And since there's a 2 after that 3, we'll round the 3 down to itself. So 0.6923. Now we'll move on to our critical thinking questions. In number 23, it asks, can the sine of an angle ever equal 2? Let's think about sine. The sine of an angle is going to equal the opposite over the hypotenuse. Can this ever equal 2? Well, we can write 2 as a fraction 2 over 1. The opposite side of that angle is greater than the hypotenuse, but we know that a leg is never greater than a hypotenuse because the hypotenuse is always the greatest length within a right triangle. Therefore, our answer is no. We cannot have the sine of an angle ever equal to 2, and that's because the hypotenuse needs to be greater than the legs of a triangle, where that opposite side is a leg. So no, the hypotenuse needs to be greater than the legs of the triangle because that opposite side is a leg, and the hypotenuse needs to be greater than the leg or greater than that opposite side. In number 24, it says the sine of x is equal to 1/3. We're to find the cosine. Sine, we know, is opposite over hypotenuse. So let's set up our triangle. If we have a triangle where the opposite side of some angle x is 1 and the hypotenuse is 3, what is this side? We can solve for that side length using the Pythagorean theorem and then plug that in for our cosine of x. So we'll have 1 squared plus, let's make this side length a variable a. So 1 squared plus a squared will equal 3 squared. 1 plus a squared equals 3 squared, which is 9. So if I subtract 1 from both sides, I'll get that a squared is equal to 8. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that that side length a is equal to the square root of 8, which we can pull out a perfect square from 8, that perfect square is 4, so the square root of 4 times 2 is the square root of 8. So A will equal 2 times the square root of 2. So if A equals 2 times the square root of 2, the cosine of x is going to be the adjacent over the hypotenuse. And since we know our hypotenuse is 3, we can now plug in our adjacent side since we solved for that, which is 2 square root of 2. So the cosine of x is 2 times the square root of 2 over 3. And with that, we wrap up our trigonometric ratios worksheet. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave it in the comments below, and I or one of your peers will respond as quickly as possible. Also, all likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, so if you haven't done that, go ahead and do that now.